This is Lenny Farley, Purdue Extension Forester, and this is a Woodland Management Moment. In this Woodland Management Moment, we're going to talk about using plastic mesh fencing to protect your newly planted seedlings from browse by white-tailed deer. Now, white-tailed deer are a natural part of our environment, but what we find oftentimes, particularly in areas surrounded by forest land or with high deer populations, it can be difficult to get hardwood seedlings established because of deer browse. And so that may call for some measures to prevent deer browse for the first few years of that tree planting's life to make sure we get those trees established to the place where they can successfully grow and occupy that site. One of our options for that protection is the plastic mesh deer exclusion fence. This is typically a mesh polypropylene fence, 7.5 to 8 feet tall. You can use any variety of post materials, wood posts, T-posts, T-posts with PVC pipe attached to them to extend them. Normally we're using two or three strands of a mono line or wire to hang this plastic mesh from. We can use fence staples to attach the mesh to the posts. And we're typically affixing some flagging so that the deer can actually see this mesh. It actually kind of disappears. Particularly for a deer that's running pretty hard trying to get away from something, and they can actually run into these and sometimes damage them. So it's a good idea to put a little bit of flagging on them. We found these to be very effective at preventing excessive browse by deer. Deer could hop over this, but they typically choose not to. It's just a little bit taller than they really like to attempt if they've got other food sources available. So it's an excellent option. We have an extension publication that talks in it extensively about the construction of these particular types of fences, so I encourage you to check that out on our extension website. There are other options for protecting your trees from deer browse. You can use the tree tubes. Typically, we recommend you use at least a 5 foot tall tree tube. These are plastic tubes that fit around the seedlings and protect them until they shoot out of the tops. A fair amount of labor and some expense associated with those, so we typically recommend if you've got more than a half acre or an acre to plant, think about looking at a fence. Less than that, you could certainly look at the tree tubes as a good option. Electrified fencing are also possibilities. There are several different approaches to that. But no matter what, talk with your forester about your tree planting plans, an assessment of the potential for deer damage on your property, and recognize you have several options to deal with that damage. In addition, and relatively new on the landscape, is through the USDA cost assistance programs for conservation practices, they have added exclusion fencing as part of the protection practices for tree plantings. And so if you're involved in those cost-sharing programs through the U.S. Department of Agriculture, that's a new option that's open for you as well. So as you're working on your tree planting plans, think about the potential pressure from white-tailed deer and some of the management activities you can take to help you get those trees established.